Hi, Jim.
Hi, Liz. How are you?
Good, thank you. You're co-head of single stock research for Goldman Sachs, and you've recently published a report on corporate dividends. Given the economic downturn, many companies are being more cautious in terms of how they allocate their cash, and that includes how they think about paying dividends to shareholders. Give us a sense of where we are with dividends right now.
Yeah, it's the dividend-paying companies are having a difficult time during this economic pullback. And obviously, in general, dividends are a very good thing. Dividends are a very good way for companies to return cash to shareholders. And obviously, investors who are seeking current yield or current income gravitate toward companies that pay a dividend. And so it's a very good social contract between a company and an investor. One of the things we've seen over the last couple of years is significant increases in dividends during good parts of the economic cycle where companies have generated significant amounts of free cash flow. However, what's happened in this most recent downdraft in the market is that the market has become very concerned that companies have a large dividend commitment that they're not going to be able to cover as the cash flows come down in this economic decline. And so the stocks of the companies that pay a large dividend have actually significantly underperformed the market during this episode. And so what we've seen is large dividend payers have underperformed the market by more than 15% since the market started to decline, as investors have become worried about those companies potentially needing to cut their dividend because of the large cash flow declines that they've seen in their business.
So as an alternative to the traditional fixed dividend, you've proposed the idea of a variable dividend. What is that?
So a variable dividend is a dividend that is tied to a percentage of the company's free cash flow, as opposed to a fixed payment amount that a company is committing to. So the idea here is if you take a company that has 1 million shares outstanding and they have a fixed dividend of $1, so there's $1 million of dividend payout that they're committing to. And that's not a problem for that hypothetical company because in the top of the cycle, they're generating $2 million in free cash flow. However, you get into an economic environment like the one we have today, and that $2 million of free cash flow may come down to $200,000 of free cash flow. And that company has $1 million fixed dividend payout that they're committed to, and therefore they're $800,000 short. And they either have to take that cash off their balance sheet, they have to go out in the market and issue equity at a depressed price in order to pay for it, or they have to issue a bond in order to cover that dividend. The variable dividend for that same company might pay out hypothetically 80% of a company's free cash flow at the top of the cycle. So of that $2 million in free cash flow at a good part in the cycle, they'll pay out $1.6 million to investors. So the investor gets a healthy dividend. But as the cycle declines and the company's free cash flow declines, so too does the dividend. So as the cash flow goes from $2 million down to $200,000, that ratio of 80% still holds. And so the investors are getting $160,000 worth of a dividend. So obviously the amount that the investor is going to get at the bottom of the cycle declines. However, the company can preserve their balance sheet capacity. They don't have to go out and borrow or issue equity at depressed prices in order to raise the capital to pay a dividend.
What about companies that borrow money to pay dividends or to do stock buybacks?
Yeah, Liz, that's a really good question because I think this vehicle can really help companies that ultimately wind up in a situation where they need to wind up issuing equity or issuing a bond at a more difficult part of the cycle in order to cover a dividend that was set in a stronger part of the cycle. And so, the dynamic of when you're at the top of the cycle and companies are buying back what wound up being expensive stock, is very inefficient because then you get to a weaker part of the cycle and sometimes companies have to issue equity to cover a dividend. And so that leads to the dynamic of a company selling low and buying high, obviously the inverse of what a company or an investor wants to be doing. And so this mechanism, which naturally allows the dividend to come down over the course of a more difficult economic environment, and prevents a company from potentially needing to go out and raising capital at a weaker part of the cycle, is really an effective way to deal with that dynamic that we've seen some companies wind up having to do.
But what kind of pushback can you imagine companies getting or having themselves against the idea of using a variable dividend?
Historically, the pushback on a concept like this has been, well, it sounds great, but the first time my free cash flow declines and therefore the dividend declines, investors are going to go ahead and sell my stock. And I thought that was always a viable pushback until we got into this period of the economic cycle, where what we've seen is companies that pay a significant dividend have significantly underperformed the market. The companies that pay a large dividend so far in this downdraft have underperformed the market by 15%. In other words, investors aren't waiting to see if the company is going to have a problem covering the dividend. They're just making the assumption on those basket of stocks that they are going to have a problem covering the dividend. And so they're aggressively selling those stocks. And so if investors are going to sell stocks of companies that pay a big dividend anyway, why not have a mechanism in place that allows the dividend to come down as the cash flow comes down so that you don't wind up in a difficult balance sheet or cash flow situation? So I think a lot of the pushback that we've heard on a concept like this over the years has been sort of mitigated by what we've seen from the stock price performance during this period in the market.
And what type of companies do you think would be most attracted to the idea of a variable dividend?
Yeah, Liz, it's a good question, and one we get a lot. I think really any company could use some form of variable dividend, but I think the companies that it's most attractive to are ones that are in cyclical businesses, ones that have a lot of free cash flow at a good part in their cycle, and not just an economic cycle, but maybe a supply side cycle. You know, I used to cover the semiconductor stocks, and this is something that we had proposed in the semiconductor industry years ago. And then in a weaker part of the cycle, you know, the cash flow gets hit particularly hard. So any cyclical industry, certainly we're seeing this in the energy space today, obviously a consumer discretionary company that has its ties to the economic cycle, any supply side driven industry where you can see downturns in the industry, even outside the confines of an economic cycle. And so I do think it's a broad group of companies that it applies to, but any company that's particularly cyclical, this is even more attractive to.
Thanks, Jim.
Thank you, Liz.